I'm going to be answering WEG 2019 chemistry past question, and this is question 16. The properties of a good primary standard include the following except A. High molecular mass, B. Low molecular mass, C. High degree of purity, D. Readily available. Now first I will define what a primary standard is. A primary standard is a chemical reagent that has high purity and is sufficiently accurate such that it is not calibrated by another reagent. Now, what are the properties of a good primary standard? We will look at the options and define each of them one after the other in order to see how each of them affects a standard or affects a primary standard. Now, high molecular mass. High molecular mass is important because a primary standard needs to have a relatively high molecular mass that allows them to be easily measured. Now, a high molecular mass enables the primary standard to be easily measured and accurately weighed without or with minimal error. Now, low molecular mass. The low molecular mass, of course, is opposite of high molecular mass. And if it is opposite of high molecular mass, it means that there will be difficulty in measurement. High degree of purity. For high degree of purity, the primary standard must have a sufficiently high degree of purity such that calibration is not needed. And lastly, readily available. Of course, a good primary standard must be available. Readily must easily be obtained without difficulty. Now, examples of primary standards include sodium chloride, zinc powder, sodium oxalate, which is NaC2O4, etc. Now, from the definitions we are given, we see that low molecular mass will make the standard to be difficult in measuring. Therefore, low molecular mass is not a good property for a primary standard to have, and therefore the answer is B, low molecular mass. Please subscribe to this YouTube channel for more past questions and answers, and also for more videos. Thank you.